Hello everybody, my name is Arun and I'm excited to talk to you about all the new APIs that we've launched from the Outlook side inside Microsoft Graph. Let's get started by looking at what we have new on the calendar side. As you know, calendars are an integral portion of Outlook and a very important part of how people organize their work and personal lives. And with these two new APIs, this year, you're going to have access to shared calendars. So this includes calendars that have been specifically shared with you, calendars to which you have delegate access, which is very common in enterprises, as well as calendars that have been shared with you as a part of a shared mailbox. The second big announcement we have this year is support for locations. Increasingly, meetings are being simultaneously run at multiple geographical locations, and the new locations API allows you to define as well as read the various locations that have been configured on individual meetings. The third big one is around conference rooms. So conference rooms and equipments are a key part of how most modern enterprises work. And now with these two new APIs, you not only get access to the various conference rooms, but also kind of the buildings or the room lists that these rooms are a part of. So on that note, let's just quickly jump in to the Graph Explorer to see some live demos of how these APIs work. So first, what I'm going to do is go to the Events API. As you can see, it's at graph.microsoft.com/me/calendar/events. And then I'm going to ask for the locations along with the subject so you can see how the new location API works. So you can see that right away, I'm able to get an array of locations where every single location that the meeting contains is a part of. Since this is a demo environment, there's only one location, but once you have multiple locations, you can start to see those details filling up here. The next API we're going to look at is Rooms. So the Rooms API is available in the beta API, and we're working on figuring out the V1 version of it. So you can see that when I hit Find Rooms, I'm going to get a list of every single room that's a part of this tenant. And if you want to look at the calendar of the room, for example, all you need to do is copy the address and then go to the /user/calendar endpoint of that particular room. In case you want to navigate the list by looking at room lists, which could be buildings, for example, you can go to the list of room lists, pick up the room list that you want to understand, copy its address, and then you can quickly go in and say you want to look at this room list. So you see that when I pass in the room list to the Find Rooms API, it's going to return me only the rooms that are a part of that particular room list. So next, let's look at the Outlook email APIs, the new APIs that we've been working on. The first one here again is access to shared mail folders. This is similar to the scenarios we discussed above. It could be delegate access, shared mailboxes, folders that are explicitly shared. The couple of interesting APIs that we have added this year are around message headers, the flag status of an email, which is often used to mark it as a task or something that you need to follow up on. And the third one is message rules. So message rules are basically Outlook rules that users can configure to kind of automatically put your messages to specific folders. So let's start by looking at message folders. So here I'm going to swap back to the V1 API because all of these have been in beta and have been promoted to the V1 endpoint. So we look at the inbox folder and then look at the message rules there. So the message rules API here, as you can see, is going to tell me that any new message that comes with abracadabra in the body or subject is going to automatically get assigned to a category called magic. In addition to assigning categories, you can obviously move it to various folders and even define fairly complex rules. So in addition to just viewing the message rules, you can also use the API to define automatic message rules, which could come in very handy if you want to apply a specific set of rules for every single user in your tenant. The next one we're going to look at is the standard messages API, which is going to return list of all your messages, but here we're going to look at the new flag and the internet message headers properties. So here you can see that for every single message, it returns me a flag status to say, has this message been flagged or not flagged? Flagged meaning there's a follow-up action. And for emails that have been delivered to me externally, you can see that there's a fairly long list of internet message headers. These can come in quite handy in a couple of scenarios. One is the security space where you want to analyze the headers to understand, you know, if this is really a safe mail and compliance angle. And the second one is sometimes there's custom data that's being passed around. For example, some CRM vendors put in custom IDs to emails for integration with other systems. So you can see that the entire set of email headers is available to you as a JSON array that you can start consuming in your app. The third set of Outlook APIs that we've been adding are around user choices. So these are settings that users have put in to kind of customize their experience. So first set of APIs are around categories. So in Outlook, you can basically assign categories to various items that not only puts them into buckets, but also allows for color coding. So one of the most common use cases where you might find yourself using categories is when you want to flag items that you want to call out as coming specifically from your app. For example, a CRM app might want to say, these set of contacts have been synced into Outlook from their CRM system, or these sets of calendar events have been imported from their external calendar. The second set of Outlook user choices are around working hours. These are very commonly used by end users to define what hours they're going to be working on, especially for folks who are traveling. So as an application developer, you want to be very conscious of these working hours because this allows you to communicate with the user at a time that's going to be most convenient and relevant for the end user. The last two new APIs are sort of metadata APIs that tell you what are all the various supported languages, locales, and time zones that can be supported for the specific user. This is again convenient if you want to let the user pick from a list of languages that can work well for him or her. So let's go ahead and first look at the categories API. So the categories API you can find at /outlook/master categories. So this again is a V1 API that has been in beta and we've tested it out and made sure it's working for a production scale. So here you're going to find that there's a list of categories that show up. These are the default categories that Outlook provides. But here again, by calling the put in patch endpoints on this API, you're going to be able to add your own categories. And these categories, once defined, can be applied to individual messages as well as events, tasks, and contacts using the categories array that's available on each of those specific objects. Let me quickly show you the supported time zones API. So this again, can be handy if you want to find out what are all the supported time zones for this particular user based on how his Exchange or Office system has been configured. And similarly, these are all the supported languages. So you can see that this user has a wide array of languages to pick from. And lastly, let's go to mailbox settings and take a look at the working hours. So here again, you can get to it directly by calling mailbox settings /working hours, or you can just go to the mailbox settings API where you're going to find working hours is included. Here for this user, you can find that this user works Monday through Friday from 8 to 5 in the Pacific time zone. But here again, you have the option of designing even more complex time zones, for example, daylight saving sort of settings, fairly easily. So just to recap, today we went through the Outlook Mail APIs, Calendar APIs, and User Choice APIs. Hope you like it. Thanks for your time.